This is a no-fluff guide to creating cinematic AI videos built specifically for interior designers and architects. If you've seen all the latest AI video demos, it might look as though we can already create full walkthroughs with just one click. Not quite yet, but what's possible right now is incredible, and it's already transforming how you can show ideas, mood, and movement in your design. I've been testing all the major tools, and in this video, I'm going to show you what actually works and how you can use AI video to make your spaces and presentations feel alive. So let's separate the real opportunities from the hype. Think of AI video as having a camera you can describe instead of operate. You write a prompt like slow pan across a Scandinavian living room with warm morning light, and the AI turns it into motion. You can start from scratch with text or from an image you already have, maybe a render, a mood board, or a photo of your project. Then the AI animates it, adding movement, light, and atmosphere. But just like in design, the results depend on how clearly you direct it. You often need a few takes to get it right, and that's completely normal and part of the experimentation process. Here's why this matters. It's one of the fastest ways to bring your ideas to life. No 3D animation studio, no expensive software. You can show light moving through a space, materials shifting across palettes, drawings turning into renderings, or the emotional rhythm of a room in seconds. Clients feel your design instead of just seeing it. And it's not just about replacing skill, it's about amplifying your creative vision with motion and storytelling. So here's your basic toolkit. Number one, an image generator or a render or a photo to create your start or end still. A video generator, tools like Runway, Kling, or Google Flow bring that still to life. None are perfect yet. The models evolve monthly, but the creative principles stay consistent. A video editor, CapCut, Premiere Pro, or DaVinci Resolve for trimming, color grading, and adding sound design. Number four, optional voice or sound tools, 11 labs for narration or artlist for music and effects. And number five, most importantly, your imagination, because this space is still wide open for experimentation. I'd start with just a monthly plan. Don't get tied into a yearly subscription. You'll need flexibility while these tools are growing. So let's go through a quick workflow so that you can see how it fits together and understand the basic principles of creating AI video. Step one, you need to generate a still image or collect a still image. We can do this in Midjourney. You can use a prompt like this, a Scandinavian living room, white linen sofa, oak floors, soft daylight through sheer curtains, minimalist decor, high realism. Now, step two, we have to bring that still into your video tool. Let's say we're using Flow and add in your motion prompt. A slow cinematic pan from left to right across the room, preserving structure and lighting, a warm morning atmosphere. If you're unsure or never have done film before, just ask ChatGPT to write a cinematic prompt in plain English. It's just that simple. Step three, generate. You'll get a short 5 to 8 second clip, a perfect moving render for your portfolio or presentation. Behind the scenes, the AI is creating motion vectors and light transitions. It's technical magic, but the effect is simple and your space feels alive. Now, don't forget to experiment. You'll need to try again and again until you find a workflow that works for you and your goals. A few things you need to avoid early on. Don't describe too many movements in one prompt. Keep it simple. Always use reference images. It leads to less guesswork and more accuracy. Keep clips short, 4 to 10 seconds. Pay attention to lighting. It's what sells realism. Think of these as motion sketches, not final renders. They're fast and expressive concept tools. So let's jump in to Higgsfield and show you a basic workflow. So most interior designers may be using video very moderately. So one of the things that I want you to understand is that most of the tools are very, very similar. So we're here in Higgsfield. Higgsfield is one of the tools that I actually don't pay a subscription for yet. I'm actually thinking of changing because it actually offers you a lot of models, as you can see here. So in order to get to this tab, you just have to find the video tab, and this is the same no matter what tool you will use, with probably the exception of Midjourney. So if you have a quick look at Runway, you will see there's a video mode. Kling also has a video mode. And essentially, the makeup of the interface for each tool is going to be very, very similar. You're going to be able to add in an image. So in this case, it's my start image. Then you can add in your prompt and then you hit generate. So with Kling and Runway, I actually have memberships too. But with Higgsfield, if you have a look at it, let me just find my tab. When I go into all of those models, you can see a select. I'm immediately asked to upgrade. So when you go into monthly, you'll see that it's $29 a month. It's quite a lot if you are only going to be using it to generate a couple of videos for your social media or for a client and so on. Just to quickly reiterate, you have a place where we upload our image. We have our prompt. One of the things that you have to understand is that the credits are calculated according to the model, according to the resolution. So in most AI video models, you will be stuck with a resolution of 720p. There is no 4K yet, so the maximum that you might find for some of the models is 1080. You'll also be able to play with your duration, and that will affect the credits that you use. This was just a very basic introduction. This is a cheap model that I chose. You can see it generated itself and it used 9 credits. So now that you've got the basics, start layering in ideas. You could try material transformations, fading between finished palettes, lighting transitions, morning to night sequences, or hybrid storytelling. Mix real footage or drawings with AI generated B-roll. These techniques are brilliant for mood films, design presentation, and standout social media reels. I've been documenting my experiments and saving prompts inside the Design for Success Circle, my free community for interior designers learning systems skills and technology. You'll find the link below in the description. AI video isn't replacing design, it's expanding it. It lets you communicate emotion, movement, and atmosphere, not just dull plans and renderings. So start small, one scene, one movement, one story. You'll be amazed how cinematic your ideas can look in just a few seconds of AI generated motion. If you found this video useful, give this video a like and check the description for free prompt templates and tool recommendations in the Design for Success Circle. And if you want to take the next step, watch my Nano Banana Photoshop tutorial. It shows how to create realistic image edits before turning them into video.